In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, I welcome you all on the first Sunday after Pentecost. Today is Trinity Sunday, and the theme is God the Holy Trinity. Let's pray. Psalm 95, 6th verse says, O come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord, our Maker. Let's pray. Our gracious Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord. Thank you for everything. Thank you, we are all alive and praise and worship you. Thank you, Lord. It's your grace that through online service we are gathered together to worship you. Now it's our request to please open our ear that we may able to hear your words carefully. Open our hearts and mouth that we may praise and worship you with our whole heart. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's we adore God by singing hymn number 10. Hymn number 10. Have thine own way, Lord, have thine own way. Thou art the potter, I am the clay.
Have thine own way, Lord, have thine own way. Holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us say a prayer of purity together.
Almighty God, to whom our hearts are open, all your hearts are known, and for whom no secrets are hid, clear the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may work with all your love and work with you upon your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
In the temple at Jerusalem, Isaiah is given a vision of the Holy One, who commissions him as a prophet. The Old Testament reading has been taken from Isaiah chapter 6 verses 1 to 8. I repeat, Isaiah chapter 6 verses 1 to 8. In the year the king Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting upon a throne, high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple. Above him stood the seraphim. Each had six wings. With two he covered his face, and with two covered his feet, and with two he flew. And one called to another and said, Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. And the foundations of the threshold shook at the voice of him who called, and the house was filled with smoke. And I said, Woe is to me, for I am lost, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips, for my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. Then flew one of the seraphim to me, having in his hand a burning coal, which he had taken with the tongs from the altar. And he touched my tongue and mouth, and said, Behold, this has touched your lips, and your guilt is taken away, and your sin forgiven. And I heard the voice of the Lord saying, Whom shall I send, and who will go for us? Then I said, Here I am, send me. This is the word of the Lord.
Responsive psalm reading. Responsive psalm is taken from Psalm 46, 1 to 6, 10 to 11. Psalm 46, 1 to 6, 10 to 11. Your response will be, God is our hope and strength. God is our hope and strength. God is our hope and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore will we not fear, though the earth be moved, and though the hills be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof rage and swell, and though the mountains shake at the tempest of the same. Response, God is our hope and strength. There is a river, the streams whereof make glad the city of God, the holy dwelling place of the Most Highest. God is in the midst of her, therefore shall she not be removed. God shall help her, and that right early. The nations make much ado, and the kingdoms are moved. But God hath sowed his voice, and the earth shall melt away. Response, God is our hope and strength. Be still, then, and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations, and I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Your response, God is our hope and strength. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, without end. Amen.
Paul's Trinitarian prayer to the Father, asking that his purpose for the church may be fulfilled in Christ through the Holy Spirit. Today's epistle reading has been taken from Ephesians chapter 3 verse 14 to 21. Ephesians chapter 3 verse 14 to 21. For this reason, I bow my knees before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named, that according to the riches of his glory, He may grant you to be strengthened with might through His Spirit in the inner man, and that Christ may dwell in your heart, through faith, that you, being rooted and grounded in love, may have power to comprehend with all the saints what is the breadth and length and height and depth, and to know the love of Christ which surpasses knowledge, that you may be fulfilled with all the fullness of God. Now to Him who by the Spirit at the work within us is able to do far more abundantly than all that we ask or think. To Him be the glory in the Church and in Christ Jesus to all generations for ever and ever. Amen. Amen. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. For gospel, we adore God by singing hymn number 106. All hail adore Trinity, all hail eternal unity, O God the Father, God the Son, God the Spirit, ever one.
Jesus said, "Now I am going to Him who sent me, Yet none of you asks me, where are you going? But because I have said these things to you, sorrow shall fill your hearts. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the counselor will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. And when he comes, he will convince the world concerning sin and righteousness and judgment. Concerning sin, because they do not believe in me. Concerning righteousness, because I go to the Father, and you will see me no more. Concerning judgment, because the ruler of this world is judged. I have yet many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all the truth. For he will not speak on his own authority, but whatever he hears, he will speak. And he will declare to you the things that are to come. He will glorify me, for he will take what is mine and declare it to you. All that the Father has is mine. Therefore I said that he will take what is mine and declare it to you. This is the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
May the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable to you, O Lord, our God, our Rock and Redeemer. Amen. Please be seated. Today is the first Sunday after Pentecost, commonly called as the Trinity Sunday, and the theme for our meditation is God the Holy Trinity. God the Holy Trinity. God the Holy Trinity means there is one God who eternally exists as three distinct persons, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. In other words, God is one in essence and three in person. All are equally omniscient, omnipresent, eternal, and unchanging, but each one has unique functions. Together, they rule the church and are the center of the faith of every believer of the Christian faith. Trinity is not a late invention, because apostolic preaching makes it clear that the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit work together for our salvation. So we invoke the presence of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit in most of our prayers. We sing the Gloria as glory to be the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. We sing the traditional doxology as praise God from whom blessings flow. Praise Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Most church services close with Paul's Trinitarian benediction as the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 14. We always offer the sacrament of baptism in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Further, there are references to the Trinity in many of the hymns the church uses regularly in its worship. Jesus, during his earthly ministry, had made his disciples to feel the presence of God. Then he had gone away. But then there was the experience of the Holy Spirit in Pentecost, after which they were surprised to find that God was present in their lives in a way that was even more real and powerful than had been true when Jesus was visibly present with them. What did this mean? It was a new way of experiencing God's presence. Yet another way, it was not a new thing. Since it heightened their sense of the one God they had always known, and known most recently in Jesus, they soon found themselves talking about the Holy Spirit as if He were God also. We have only to open the New Testament and read to confirm the fact that the writers used language that refers to God as the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. It is true that it is not there in the form of doctrine, but the experience of the Trinity is there, the experience that made necessary the formulation of the doctrine. If Christians were going to tell the world what they believed about God, it will help us to understand the teaching that there are three persons within the divine nature, if we remember that God is love. Love cannot exist alone. When we love, we always love someone, as a wife, her husband, or a father, his son. So love flows between the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. The Christian teaching about the Trinity is not the result of man's reasoning or arguments. It is rather an attempt to understand how God has revealed Himself in the history of our world. It is the result of Christian experience based on the events recorded in the Bible, not on the reasoning of human philosophers. Christians believe that God has revealed Himself in the world by His actions, and that He has acted in a threefold way. Let us try to see briefly how this came about. The threefold name, Matthew chapter 28, verse 19. God the Father. God is one. He is the creator of everything. The history of Israel is the story of how this truth was given and how it was kept. Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 4. In the beginning, God created all things. There was no other beside Him. The first Christians never questioned this truth. God the Savior. God the Father planned our salvation. He is the planner of our salvation. He made possible the life of Jesus, the death of Jesus, the resurrection and ascension of Jesus, and the pouring out of the Holy Spirit. Jesus came in the world. He knew no sin. He spoke with authority. He came back from the dead. Thus, the disciples were brought to believe that Jesus was the Christ, the Son of the living God. Thus, God the Son carried out our salvation. What the Father had planned for us, the Son did for us. Jesus lived. The miracle of Jesus were not mere wonders, but they were mighty works, evidences of the fact that God has visited His people. They were also signs of the kingdom of God, the power of the age to come. Jesus died. The price which Jesus paid with His death as a ransom for many was determined by God. However, the human responsibility is laid directly on the Jews. Their crime is made worse by the fact that they employed Gentiles to crucify their Messiah. Although human judges had put Jesus to death, a higher court had reversed the decision. The death of Jesus did not put an end to the connection between God and His chosen people, but their hatred became an instrument for the fulfillment of the divine plan. Jews and Gentiles as well were offered through the resurrection another possibility of believing in Jesus and participating in salvation. Jesus has not only been raised from the dead, he has also been exalted, as prophesied in Psalm 110, verse 1, Mark 12, 35 and 36, and enthroned in the heavens, from where he now exercises his messianic reign, in the earliest apostolic creed. God is the sanctifier. What the Father planned for us and what the Son did for us, the Holy Spirit applies to us. Jesus received the Holy Spirit at the beginning of his public ministry, equipping him for his activities. The same Spirit is now given to Christ's representatives on earth. The Holy Spirit applies to us believers the benefits which Christ gained through his death. The very first thing we must understand about the Holy Spirit is that he is indeed God. He is the third member of Godhead. It is fitting, therefore, that equal reverence, respect and honor should be ascribed to him. He is God's gift to every believer. When a person believes in Jesus and receives the salvation, he offers the Holy Spirit, comes to live in the believer, imparting spiritual life. He comes to dwell within the believer, to minister to him personally. As well as giving the Holy Spirit to dwell in the believer, God also wants to fill and baptize the believer with the Holy Spirit to empower him to serve and glorify God in the world. The threefold grace. Apart from the reference given above, Matthew chapter 28, verse 19, there is only one other direct reference to the Trinity in the New Testament. It is found in 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 14. It is used as benediction or final blessing whenever and wherever Christians meet together. We hear the words frequently but do not often think about them. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Here expressed in different but very beautiful way is the essence of what the Christian believes about God. The implications of this doctrine Trinity are vitally important for Christian experience and life. It means that God is revealable. Revelation is as natural for God as it is for the sun to shine. Before there had been any created being, there was self-revelation within the Trinity. The Father revealing to the Son, the Father and the Son revealing to the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit communicating that revelation within the being of God. It means that God is communicable. As the sun shines, it communicates its light and heat and energy. So if God is a fellowship within himself, he can let that fellowship go out to his creatures and communicate himself to them according to their capacity to receive. This is what happened supremely when he came to redeem humans. He let his fellowship bend down to reach outcast man and lift him up. And so, because God is Trinity, he had something to share. It is his own life and communion. Third, it means that Trinity is the basis of all true fellowship in the world. Since God is within himself a fellowship, it means that his moral creatures who are made in his image find fullness of life only within a fellowship. This is reflected in marriage, in home, in society, and above all in the church, whose koinonia is built upon the fellowship of the three persons. Christian philosophy is therefore the divinest thing on earth, the earthly counterpart of the divine life, as Christ indeed prayed for his followers. In John chapter 17 verse 21, that they may all be one, even as thou, Father, art to me, and I in thee, and that they also may be in us. Fourth, it gives variety to the life of the universe. There is, as we have seen, diversity in the life of God. God the Father designs, God the Son creates, God the Holy Spirit quickens, a great diversity of life and operation and activity. For that reason, we can realize that if the universe is a manifestation of God, we can expect a diversity of life within the whole of the created universe. We think that the so-called uniformity of nature is utterly untrue. All the wonders of creations, all the forms of life, all the movement in the universe are a reflection, a mirroring of the manifold life of God. There is no monotonous sameness, no large-scale uniformity of pattern or nature reflects the many-sidedness of the nature and character of the living God. Thus, God revealed himself as God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit in the experience of Christians. Christians sought to express this truth about the Holy Trinity in ways which would not endanger the unity of the one God. It is this that we find unfolding in the pages of the New Testament. May God Almighty strengthen our faith and beliefs in the Holy Trinity to worship and praise Him. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, you have given us grace by the confession of a true faith to acknowledge the glory of the eternal Trinity, and in the power of your divine majesty to worship the unity. Keep us steadfast in this faith and worship, and bring us at last to see you in your one and eternal glory. O Father, who with the Son and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns one God forever and ever. Amen.
Let us all rise up and say the Nicene Creed together. Nicene Creed. We believe in one God,
the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten from the Father, Lord from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, one in being with the Father, through whom all things are made. For us and for our salvation, we came down from heaven by the power of the Holy Spirit, who gone all the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified in the Pontius Pilate. He suffered, died, and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in fulfillment of the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of our Father. He will come again in your glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will not have an end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in the Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge your baptism for the forgiveness of sins, to look for the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us thank God for his goodness and loving kindness. Today, let us thank him for the gift of the Holy Spirit and by him revealing to us the wonderful mystery of your divine life We pray kindly keep us steadfast in this faith and grant us the vision of your endless glory. Lord, hear our prayer.
Let our prayer come unto thee.
Now, in our intercession, let us join our prayer for the whole human family with the unceasing prayer of Christ the Lord.
Heavenly Father, we pray for justice and peace in the whole world and for fullness of life for everyone. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all who live in this place, for the removal of all that divide us from each other, and for true harmony in our country, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all engaged in agriculture, industry and commerce, and for all workers, skilled and unskilled, and for all those who defend our country, Lord, in your mercy. For teachers and students, scientists, artists and writers, and for all who influence the minds and hearts of others, Lord, in your mercy. For those who are suffering, the poor and hungry, the destitute and oppressed, the unemployed, the sick and the dying, and for all who help them, Lord, in your mercy. For all to whom authority is interested in this and other countries, and especially for our President, the Prime Minister, the Governor, and the Chief Minister of this state, and for all who have power over other people, Lord, in your mercy. For the unity of all Christian people, and for their witness and service in the world, Lord, in your mercy. For your whole church in our country, for its council and leaders, especially for P.D. Singh, our moderator of the Church of South India, and Metropolitan of the Mathoma Church, for Baske, our bishop, for our presbyters, and for all our other ministers of your church, that they may be faithful in their ministry. Lord, in your mercy, that with all your people who have faithfully served you in this life, we also may share the eternal joy of your kingdom. Lord, in your mercy. Hasten, Heavenly Father, the coming of your kingdom, and grant this petition which we offer in the name of your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Beloved, our Lord Jesus Christ said, "The Lord our God is only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. This is the first commandment. Second is this, love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us therefore confess our sin in penitence and faith, firmly resolved by God's grace to keep his commandment and live in love and peace with all people."
Pray together. Almighty God, our Holy Father, we have sinned against you and against one another, in thought, word, and deed, in the evil we have done, and the good we have not done. Through ignorance, through weakness, through our own willful fault, we are to be sorry and repent of all our sins, for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all our sins, and grant that we may serve you in this life, to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, who forgives all who forgive one another and truly repent of their sins, have mercy on you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you, God.
are the body of Christ. In the one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body. Let us pursue all that makes for peace and builds up common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Also with you.
Offertory hymn, hymn number 109. O God, our help in ages past, our hope for years to come, our shelter from the storming blast, and our eternal home.
Let us present these offerings and with them ourselves for the service of the Divine Majesty. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. Almighty God, Creator of the world, we ask you to accept these offerings, bread and wine, for the glory of your name and the good of your people, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord is here.
The Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
Give them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is not only right, it is our duty and our joy, Holy Father, Heavenly King, Almighty and Eternal God, always and everywhere to offer you thanks and praise through Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord, for he is your true and living Word. Through him you have created all things from the beginning and formed us in your own image. Through him you enlighten everyone who comes into the world, and from age to age have raised up prophets and wise men and women to point the way to you. Through him you have freed us from slavery of sin, giving him to be born as man, to die upon the cross, and to rise again for us. Through him you give your holy and life-giving Spirit to make us your children and the first fruits of your new creation.
Praise. of Christ,
his life in us and delivered in
heaven. As our Savior Christ has taught us, so we pray, our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, forgive us our sins, and forgive those who sin against us. Do not bring us into time of trial,
but deliver us from evil.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours,
now and forever.
Amen. The prayer of humblesses, let's say together, we do not presume to come to this table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your unfolding great mercies. We do not put the things from the together of the cross and your table, but you are the same Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy.
Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so be the flesh of your Son, Jesus Christ, and drink his blood, that our sinful bodies and souls may be made clean by his most precious body and blood,
that we may have one blood in him
and he in us.
Amen. The Spirit and the Bride say, come, and let him who hears say, come. He who testifies to these things says, surely I am coming soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. Having now in faith received this holy sacrament, let us give thanks to God. Almighty God, we thank you for giving us
with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you ourselves to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work your praise and glory.
God which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Let us give thanks to Almighty God for our near and dear ones who are celebrating their birthday and marriage anniversary this week. The following members are celebrating their birthday this week. 30th May, Ms. Aditi Panna and baby Vanya Bakla. 31st May, Ms. Ann Jacob. 1st June, Mrs. Anita Mahapatra, Mr. Ajay Michiari, Mr. Rabindranath Tuddu, and Mr. Anmol Purti. 2nd June, Mr. Asis Kumar. 4th June, Ms. Purvi Minj, Mr. Kenny James, and Dr. Sabnam Tirki. 5th June, Mr. Rowan Stewart and Mrs. Grace Tirki. And following members are celebrating their wedding anniversary this week. 26th May, Mr. Rajiv Mandal and Mrs. Nupur Mandal. 28th May, Mr. Mayur Khalpo and Mrs. Kavita. As the psalmist says in Psalm 95, "Oh, come, let us sing to the Lord, let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation. Let us come into His presence with thanksgiving. Let us make a joyful noise to Him with song of praise." Let's pray. Our gracious Heavenly Father, our God, Your love we can't measure, and Your blessings are without number. We give thanks for life of our near and dear ones who are celebrating their birthday and marriage anniversary, and remember the blessing which You have showered on them in past days. For their weakness You were always there, strength. In their darkness, light. In their sorrow, comfort and peace. Thank You, Lord, for Your mercy. Again, we humbly surrender all our near and dear ones. Lord, in Your mighty hand, You just take care. Be with them in their life journey. Shower more blessing on them. Touch and help them. Lord, help them that they may count their days wisely. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We continue to pray for those who are celebrating their marriage anniversary this week. God, our Father, You have taught through Your Son that love is a fulfilling of the law. Grant to Your servant that through their love for each other, they may grow in love for You and other until they live. And through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with You and Holy Spirit, one now and ever. Amen. Let's we offer our special homage and continue pray for all departed souls due to COVID-19. Their names are as follows: Robert Stanley Huck, Vidyavati Pankaj, Somendra Baroi, Prem Rajesh Soy, Prafullo Agarwal, Kanan Bala John. As the scripture says, Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who live and believe in me will never die. Let's pray. Almighty and everlasting God, you are always present to help us in our trouble and shelter us when we are overwhelmed. You are the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the same yesterday, today and forever. And for your love there is no end. Grant that your presence be more real to us, our sorrow. Fill us with faith in you and brighten our heart with light and peace through the promises of Christ. Lord, your name of old is Redeemer. We bless and praise you for Jesus Christ, your Son, in whom you came to seek and to save the lost. We thank you, and he became a human being and walked the dark way before us, giving us rest by his sorrow and life by his death. We praise you that he abolished death and brought eternal life to us by his glorious resurrection. And now we rejoice that those who die in him do not perish but are present with the Lord. Lord, you are the refuge of the living and rest of those who have died and the hope of the whole creation. We praise you for all your saints who have departed this life with the faith in the risen Redeemer. And now we especially thank you for your servants who are no more with us, but your promise of life in Christ fills our moment of sorrow with hope. We bless O Lord for all your loving kindness to them through the year of their earthly life, for all they were by nurture and by grace of those who love and cherish them. One by one you are gathering your children into the world of light, and we praise you, O Father, for this pilgrim who has now finished their earthly race and now gone to the city of God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Now may I request to our secretary, English service, please come forward and make the announcements.
A very happy and a blessed good morning to all of you all. In the loving name of our Lord Jesus Christ, on behalf of the English Service Committee, we would first of all like to thank our Lord Bishop for leading us today on our online church service. Thank you, Lord Bishop. We are truly blessed by your presence. We would like to thank our clergy for leading us in our online church service. Thank you, Reverend Miguel Bakla and Reverend Bimal Barla. We would also like to thank all those members who have joined us today in our online church service, our congregation, our choir, our guest, and all those who have joined us for the first time or after a long time. We would like to thank Reverend Bimal Barla for his inspiring message on today's theme, God, the Holy Trinity. Thank you, Reverend, once again. Notice the election for Ranchi Pastorate has been deferred. As soon as the new dates will be announced, we will let you know. But please still be careful, wear your mask, sanitize yourself, take vaccine, and keep praying for us and for each other. Thank you and God bless you.
Thanks to our secretary, the service. Now we give thanks to Almighty God by singing hymn number 107. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God Almighty, early in the morning our song shall rise to thee.
Oh,
Pray. Our gracious Heavenly Father, thank you for your gracious presence. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for everything. Thank you for your begotten Son, Jesus Christ, his blood and body. Lord, thank you. Thank you reminded us that the Trinity is the essential part of our life. Lord, we surrender everything. Help us, guide us, and hold us with your Spirit that we may establish your kingdom through our daily life. Lord, send us out that we establish your kingdom through our life and give witness. Through Jesus Christ we pray.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of God.